Wish me luck. 406. Oh, it changed too. Okay, I'm gonna write this down just in case. 406. Now, I'm gonna try this on not the rotary dial one, that other one. Now the only problem is, how do we get there again? Oh, I don't remember. 406. Now, I don't know if that's it. First of all, well, I don't know why we go in here. I always think because you can go in here, there's some reason to go in here, right? Fly, butterfly! What's that say? Dracon? I don't know. Damn, it's just gonna be flailing through different areas again, isn't it? Because I don't... At some point, I'll get it memorized, but by then, the game will be over. Yeah, this is a dead end. We'll try here. Now, this goes to... This goes to the spaceship. And we don't want to be there. Let me just check. I'm pretty sure, but I think we can see where we want to go from here. I don't know. I don't know what the deal is with the teleporting, like why that's a thing. Yeah, this is so we want to be... Oops. I'm not sure. I'm not sure where it is. It's somewhere up through another winding passage like this. Trying to think. It's not through all that. It's somewhere... somewhere over there. Try through here. Whoop. That would be cool if this was it. It is. Alright. This will be exciting if we can get in here. Crossing my fingers that I have it right. 406. I'm a freaking genius. Just to let you guys know, I am... So far I have not consulted a single walkthrough, paragraph, anything. I am figuring this crap out. I mean, maybe it's easy. But I'm just glad I'm figuring it out on my own, because every time I do that, well, I don't know, it's just more genuine. So I heard a hum, I had to move my, I had to move my phone because it fell, and so I had to hold it, and it makes that hum. And I'm, vote for Joseph. I'm using, really only using the phone to time my playthroughs, that's where it really matters. I'm way past the prescribed amount anyway. Vote for Joseph. Oh, there's another here. What's the sense in that? I don't know. You can also lock yourself in, I guess. Can we close the door? No, it slides up. Never mind. Oh, there's a door. Just gonna look around in here. Oh. This is... Are we up the top level of the starship? A spaceship? Whatever? Train? Mayors. Luther Roscoe. 500 BH to 3 BH before Hunrath? AH, after Hunrath. Got it. I know what it stands for. Because Carl Hunrath, he made this place, or well, helped found it. So, Carl Hunrath from 0 to 10, 220 AH. John Farley for 10 to 20 AH to 13 140 AH. So these are either years or it's their own term of measurement because we might be on a different planet. We're on some kind of patchwork planet or something. You know, with bits and pieces from different worlds. Kind of reminds me of for anyone who might know. Marvel Superhero Secret Wars from the 80s, a 12-issue limited series, which, I don't know, just it had this place called the Battle World, which was basically set up by this being called the Beyonder, and it was basically, you know, an easy way to have these heroes and villains battle each other without, you know, impacting the rest of the Marvel Universe, I guess. So it was an easy, you know, battleground to just transport them on, and once the wars were over, they were transported back, that kind of thing. But the whole thing was just interesting. It was a patchwork of different planets. Some known, some unknown. That's what this kind of reminds me of. So Benjamin Sims, 13140 AH to 16945 AH. Carolyn Farley. So she was the mayor at one point. So that's her community center. We saw her little hologram. 16945 AH to 16975 AH. Relatively short. Her term as mayor. Oh, and Joseph Peter Jansen, 16975 AH to present. So vote for Joseph. I guess he won. We got stuff. Which one do I read first? Oh, this has to do with the generator or whatever the hell is in that pond over there that we haven't been able to get to. The rate of dissipation is sensed and regulated automatically. The power is collected through Valane-engineered extruded cables that attach directly to the dome membrane. When the maximum power level is exceeded, the dissipation phase is triggered, creating an electrical charge followed by a discharge into the water. Through electrolysis, an amount of hydrogen and oxygen is generated. We capture some of these elements for our own use, but the great majority is released into our atmosphere. This gassing might be a cause for concern were it not for the ecosystem's ability to filter and maintain our atmosphere at our ideal at near ideal levels. Excess H&O content and pressure generated by the process is rebalanced quickly by the membrane. And as you know, we discourage swimming when the bladder is operational. Regards CW. CW Cecil, yeah. Alright, put that back. That's page 2. So it starts with this. Mr. Mayor, At your behest, here is the information pertaining to the Bleeder, its history, and some of the engineering behind it. The Bleeder project was designed and built at the request of Mayor Sims to collect and dissipate the ever-increasing power in the entire ecosystem. Mayor Sims was reluctant to allow the system to come to fruition, as he and others had become suspicious of Mayor Frawley's death. He believed that without knowing... Really? Suspicious of Mayor Frawley's death. He believed that without knowing more precisely what would happen to the cell wall at fruition, it was ill-advised to allow it to possibly open, thus allowing what might be outside in and what might be inside out. The system has the capacity to throttle all four connected worlds. So we have one we haven't seen yet. Right, I don't know which world is which. No spoilers, guys. Although, by the time you watch this episode, I might be done with it. I'm not sure. Depends. No spoilers. But we've been to two of those worlds. So one of them is either the Valine, the Mofang, or the Arai. And the second one, ditto. The system has the capacity to throttle all four connected worlds. The idea, as you are well aware, is to suppress the ecosystem power and thus inhibit full maturity of the trees. It was postulated, and since became apparent, that this suppression will keep whatever unknown maturity process from happening and grant us direct control over tree fruition. For future reference, take a picture of all documents from now on. As it is, there might be some more we missed in other areas. So there's another door. Warning! Right, we've seen this before. Oh. And this theme comes up when we look at it. Do not approach anything that even remotely resembles this diagram unless it has been disabled. I wonder... I'm just going to take a picture for that, because we're bound to come across that at some point. For something, may all your doors stay open. For who? And why was it crossed out? Mayor, maybe? Another one like the one we saw. It's a little bit suspenseful music, I think. Yeah, we've seen a bunch of these. Iowa. DCTD. I don't know if it has a connection, but we've seen these in the garage. North, south, east, instead of west, we have O. I'm going to have a lot of pictures by the time we're done here. I'm glad for that feature. Do I have to somehow make that equal that? Well, we have a west here. This keeps changing. What's it say? North Carolina. How do I put this back? Thank you. What does it say? I want to zoom in. Roscoe is one of the mayors. I can't really see it. that well from here. Rasko's the first one. So I wonder what the world was what this land was like before Hunrath. Like, they didn't have electricity and the amenities that they have set up. That's interesting. AH, Special Council Session 2, discussed final approval of Farley's plan with regard to the imminent attack. The full council vote was unanimous, and I gave my final approval. Preparations update. Farley says the tunneling is almost complete. I guess that's my head, not someone behind me. Tham informs us that the Valanes just completed their construction and have started testing. 17126AH, I guess if these are days, these might be individual days. At least as far as we can tell from the sun setting. If the sun does set here, I don't even know. Special Council Session 12. No one attended. I will inquire as to reason for their absence. 17127AH. This is the next day, I'm guessing. It appears that the council members feel... The head moving with the shadow is distracting to me, sorry. It appears that the council members feel like we're having too many meetings. Since the plan has been approved, perhaps we can reduce our meeting to every 2 days for now. So those are days. They have... Instead of marking years, it's by days. So hold on. Sorry, I'm gonna hear a hum. Because I want to use this thing. Where's... Yeah. Calculator. You may or may not be hearing a hum. So anyway, 17125. Divided by 365. 46 years up to this point. After Hunrath, mind you. There were people here before Hunrath. So, 46.917. So, I'm just gonna write this down, I don't know. 17125AH equals 47 years. That's why, so I want to figure all this out. Why don't they think in years like we do? Alright, so I'm going to go back to my timer, at least for now. Alright. Alright, so every 2 days meetings now. Except they had one the next day anyway. Special Council Session 13. Cecil will provide a new key code for the lower lock in the next few days. The lower lock. What's the lower lock? Cecil was concerned about any survivors not having access, so it was decided that we would conceal the code in Farley's house and give the residents the location as they were being chambered. I also had him change the upper tower access code. Yeah, we need that. A clue to that code has been placed under the direction of our first mayor. Okay. Under the direction. So maybe that... The BH number. I have decided, 17129AH. They're still having it every day, I'm assuming. I mean, if one day is... If 17127 is like the equivalent of 2 days, that would be really annoying. So 17129AH, I have decided to bring some of the more important mayor's logs with me for chambering. What is chambering? Like storing away? Specifically, the initial Hunrath log, and then the logs that document the history of our conflict with the Mofang. I think we would have an extra chamber available for historic documents. Yeah, I want to read those. So I'm gonna just be taking screenshots as we go. Oh no, no, don't put it away. 17:130 AH. So still, next day. Special Counsel Session 14. Only Tharim attended. He informed me that, because of the dire circumstances, the others were either extremely busy or not inclined to have long discussion about the situation. I told him I would suspend the regular Special Counsel Sessions and we would simply meet as the need arose. 17:131 AH. Still next day. I paid a visit to Farley today. I asked her to check on the availability of a chamber for the documents. So that is true, actually. Not every log here. For some reason, I thought a special counsel session 11, 12. So 126 was 12. 13 was 28. And 30 was the next one after that, 14. So they made them less and less frequent. And then head moving is so annoying. Like, if it was me, I'm, like, purposely, like, trying to stop my head from moving. Not realizing, well, I am realizing, but it's kind of like a subconscious thing. Stop moving your head, and I can't stop that. 17:135 AH. I've spent the last few days collecting documents. I've divided them into two categories, chambered and vaulted. The vaulted are less important, but obviously worth making an effort to save. They can be moved into Farley's vault area. I guess that's in the community center. The vaulted category will also include any books that we've managed to collect through the years. There was a stack of books there, and I couldn't look at them. 17:137 AH. With less than a week remaining, crap, sorry guys, before chambering begins, the population is tense. We've had several town hall meetings to try to answer any questions, but the realities of the current situation make it difficult to assuage fears. 17:138 AH. Farley has informed me that there is one final confirmation from Chavar. If Farley doesn't hear from her by the end of 17:141 AH, then there is no turning back. There's an odd justice to Farley's plan and whatever the Mofang's bastards send to kill us will be returned back to them. 17:140 AH, Special Counsel Session 15. A special meeting was called to go over the plans for the final time. Farley had several instruction sheets to distribute, the Mofang weapon illustration, a list of all souls that will be used as a basis for the chambering manifest, and a thorough summary of the battle plans. These will be distributed as necessary. No word from Chavar? I'm guessing that's a V. Chavar? So 17:141, we don't hear from Chavar. Right, so that's the date. Farley tells me that there will be at least one chamber available for historic documents. Any other extra chambers will be loaded with emergency provisions and medications in case either Hunrath or Marae are completely destroyed. No word from Chavar. Which means no turning back. 17:142 AH. No word from Chavar. Death is on our doorstep. Curse the Mofang devils to hell. 17:143 AH. I am leaving to be chambered. This journal will remain here to inform any future souls of what our last days were like. So they put themselves into some kind of stasis or something? I think this is the second... Yeah, because I didn't take... I don't think I took a photo of this. I definitely didn't take a photo of this. Okay. So this, it says something under direction of our first mayor. Oh, Roscoe, the direction. Well, how do I know what direction it is? It keeps moving. Unless it's just North Carolina is the clue. Maybe we need to look for the license plate for North Carolina. Books. There's something here. What are you? You change colors. Huh. Wow, award for community excellence. What's the meaning of this thing? Huh. What does this signify? So they're just hoping people will pick up on these obscure clues they left. Luckily, we have. Alright, so this goes... I'm assuming we can open that now. Oh, wow. Alright, before I go that way... I'm thinking one of these areas might lead to somewhere that we've been to and we just couldn't get through. Yeah, I remember going up here. I think. Oops. There's a button, right? I'm pretty sure I tried to remember opening that. But in any case, that goes out to where we know. And we've also got this. Not sure if that will move. Let's take a look out here. So excited. Oh! Hello? A new one! The tree!
This is the tree. It has been here in Hunrath for as long as anyone can remember. Its health is intimately tied to everything in our little greenhouse.
Hmm.
Our cell we live in. Our ecosystem. It has provided many surprises over the years. Including some interesting seeds that you will learn more about. Many have postulated, yet we really know very little about its origins.
Hmm.
But we do know it should be cherished and protected.
Indeed. Okay. The tree, I'm guessing, is that. We definitely have a lot to explore. Have I been here? I might have been here. I might have even heard that message. What? I heard something beeped. Hear something beep? I wonder if there's any reason for trying to go up on there. Didn't hear a beep this time. Now we already turned this water on. That's the entrance to the tree. How do I get in there? A gate with no obvious, unless it goes up, but this track lifts up. The elevator might control that. So this just goes all the way around. Okay. I can deal with that. Now... of course not. Can't be that easy. There's another button here, though. Unless that just turns it on. Damn it. What's this little portal all about? So how do I... do I have to get power to this area? Power, yeah, we need. Then I can get down there. There's more stuff down there. Anything else to mess with? That's odd looking, isn't it? Like there's something stored in there. There is no crouch button, so I can't kneel down to see what might be in there. Well, in any case, it says... I know I have the photos, but I can just look right here. Okay. A new code for the lower lock. Okay, I'm guessing the lower lock leads down there, then. Cecil was concerned about any survivors not having access, or decided that we would conceal the code in Forley's housing at the residence location. I also had him change the upper tower access code. Yeah. The upper tower we need to get to. Under the direction of our first mayor. Oops. Whoops. So stay tuned for next episode when we try to find that code. Which has something to do with North Carolina, I believe. Yes, I think. I'm pretty sure that's it. Thanks again for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.